Hi there, I'm Laurencio, and in this video I'm going to talk about Nier Automata, and tell you my opinion if it's a masterpiece or not.
Nier Automata is probably a game you've never heard of, or that game that many say it's a hidden gem you should definitely play. But is it a masterpiece? In my opinion, no, but it's on the way of being one. And even if I don't consider the game a masterpiece, I admit that it's a very good title you should try out one day. The combat especially is amazing. It has depth and still remains fun to play. You can shoot infinite bullets with R1 and use two swords, you can change these swords with different weapons, the game is varied. You have multiple routes in the game. You have route A, B, C, D and E, and there are 26 different endings. The first route you play as 2B, which has in my opinion the best combat. It's the one described before. After playing as 2B, you replay the game from 9S's perspective, and the combat changes. Instead of hacking and slashing, now the combat is focused around hacking. You'll see the hacking minigame plenty when you play as 9S. Also with this route, I have my complaint. You play the very same story as with 2B, again with 9S. It's true that you get more cutscenes that explain the background more, but still, I didn't like that I had to replay the game again in order to get new story elements. Anyway, after you replay the story with 9S, you play as A2 and 9S. A2 has a similar combat style to 2B, only that instead of self-destructing, she can go berserk for a short period of time. I like this story a lot. It's unique, engaging, and it's deep. You can start reflecting on the story and find new perspective. You can extract many philosophical questions from playing the game. It tells about the state of intelligent AI that gains emotions. Even if it sounds like the robot story cliche, it isn't really. The story is unique. And aside of the combat, the story is the best part of the game. Also, as I said, the game has depth. You can craft new items. You need to gather materials to upgrade some stuff, others you can upgrade with money, you can equip dozens of chips, each with different stat boosting abilities, you can buy new weapons, new abilities for your pod, also the game has side quests. And from here I want to tell you why I don't consider the game a masterpiece. The side quests are annoying. You have to backtrack so much you'll start to hate seeing the same locations for 25 hours. You get a mission, it sends you for example to the desert to collect something, then you need to get back to the mission giver. You have fast travel, yes, but it just makes you watch loading screens instead of giving you something interesting. What I mean is that in this brief missions where you have to just go, fetch something, come back, you are watching more loading screens than actually playing something. There are exceptions too. Some side quests have a nice story and they are interesting, but others are just fetch quests. For me, the side quests were worth playing only because you receive items and money to upgrade your character. The main story has backtracking too, but it's far less than in side quests. Side quests were so annoying to me, I hated to see that I'm just running back and forth just to bring something back. Also, there are plenty of game logic moments. I know every game has those moments, but here the game logic was more obvious than in others, especially in level designs. In the game, you don't really get free roam. You get more of a sandbox with big spaces, and exploration consists of finding out which invisible barrier is not an invisible barrier. Plenty of times, I was stopped by an invisible barrier. The exploration doesn't let you freedom. You need to go on the routes the developers want you to go. And for me, a casual speedrunner, finding shortcuts is always something I try in video games. Also, navigating the map is more of a chore than it should be, at least for me it was. User interface feels sloppy and stiff. But aside of this, I can only praise the game. I didn't tell you about boss battles yet. I mean, each boss battle is unique. Boss battles have unique strategies and gimmicks, and I like it. Also, I like the difficulty settings in the game. It goes from the game playing itself to nail-bitingly difficult. And each different difficulty is, just like its name says, easy is very easy and hard is really hard. Also, the game has some attention to details here and there, and small details are always a pleasant surprise. And also praiseworthy in the game is that it combines multiple gameplay elements, I mean multiple gameplay styles. You get levels like this, or levels where you side scroll, or levels where you shoot, but in a different way. The game is very varied. Overall, while I don't consider Nier Automata a masterpiece because of the inconveniences I had with it, I admit that the game is very good, and if you ever get your hands on it, you should definitely play it, as it's a very good game you're missing out on. Okay, so this was the video. If you liked it, please hit the like button and subscribe. If you want to financially support me in my pursuit to review as many video games as possible, you can do that on Patreon or on the channel's membership section. You will help me a lot. If you want, you can follow me on Twitch, Instagram or Discord. And if you want to see another video of mine, just wait till I stop talking and there will be thumbnails of other videos I've made. Thanks for watching.